The following is a presentation of TFNN. It is now time for the Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman.
Now, 15th of October, and in moments we're going to get some, what is this, White House latest proposal from House GOP and another ransom demand. Oh, getting exciting. All right, so I don't do anything here with the politics. We just look at the markets, and I look at the Chapman Wave as part of a fractal. In other words, there's a certain methodology that gets repeated over and over and over again, certain pattern, certain waveform. If you're looking at the two-minute chart of the E-minis that I'm showing right here, whoops, let me get it right. There it is, 2 minutes. Two-minute chart, you'll see that the object of the Chapman Wave is to go from the most identifiable lowest low bar and to count very easy. You just count at least four successively higher peaks. There are other techniques I use. The techniques that I use are many moving averages, the MACD, the slow stochastic, etc. Does it matter that it's a two-minute chart? No. Why? Look, here is a 120-minute chart. Goes from the 1640 round number low of Wednesday a week ago to peak A, B, C, D, pulls back sharply from E right at that what became a trend line and what I call an inside track repellent resistance area. And what happens is it pulls back where? To the inside track propellant area. It's trying to hold it, but it then bounces to a peak. Oops, that should be an inverted V. That's the consistency of this. There it goes, inverted V. And at 1709.75, the stochastic and MACD indicate that it's about to turn down. And what does it do? It reverses down very sharply. Now, I've heard Steve talk a lot about his RSI 4 and RSI 5. I love to combine whenever I can another technique just to see how it fits in with my work. And, in fact, what it does is it gives certain points of reference to pullbacks in the peaks itself. So far, that's the only way I can actually use it for my purpose at this particular point, but I love to be looking at new concepts and new ideas and just moving the number on the different moving averages to a different time frame because you know, other people do a tremendous amount of work. And then what you get to do is you get to see if it relates to your work. In other words, when I teach my courses or I do my webinars, what I love to see is that very soon afterwards someone says, oh, I've been using this particular technique, but if I added just a little bit of the Chapman Wave, this particular aspect, I get a much better result. To me, that's wonderful. Why? Because all of a sudden, it isn't mine. I always refer this to back to when I teach clarinet. I've done this just for years and years in my adult life. I was a professional musician. I still have a few students left. When they look at me and say, is that how it goes? I look at them with the same look and say, is that how it goes? After all, if you are interpreting something, I want to hear your interpretation, not mine. So at a certain point, it's going to reflect your thinking. And then what happens is a new technique just becomes an evolving and a constitutional part of your digestive system. Let's put it that way in terms of market analysis. So I'm going to be experimenting with that for my own way. And thank you, Steve, for introducing us to this particular concept. Now, here's something else. There's a single leg A up in the daily chart. You made a peak D. Remember, we spoke about this just a moment ago. Concept of the Chapman Wave is to get you to a peak D, at least a peak D, in a buy signal going to a buy mode. And lo and behold, from the 1618's low back in late August, you've got peak A, B, C, D, and at 1726.75 on the 19th of September. Let me just type it in so I don't have to keep looking to see what it is. 19th of September, you get a pullback that goes all the way down to 1640 round number low. That's where the 120-minute kicks in. I love to use these different time frames because and allows you to go from one period to a much longer period. So, okay, let's get all the numbers done. That's just a little quick synopsis of my work. And now let me do this. I had a couple of questions. One of the questions is, wait a minute, in the S&P, let me just go to the cash S&P. I'll tell you the numbers in a moment. The Dow is down 42 at 15,258. The S&P is down 3.42 at 1706. The composite index is only down 2 at 3813. The gold index is down, gold itself is down 6.5 at 1270. You've got silver down 15 cents at 2120. Most importantly here, you've got bonds, which are only up a penny at 138.08. You know, it's so fascinating because bonds have been stuck in a trading range, and I believe that that's what the Fed would like. At least no greater move up in rates. Doesn't have to move down all that much, but just stick it here. Just leave it at a very low level. Now, the other thing is, in looking at the S&P, there are a couple of things that I wanted to look at. Just let me quickly say that high-grade copper is at 330, platinum's at 1379. You've got crude oil down again at about 102, and the dollar is up 37 cents at 80.68. Now, this is something with the euro down. You've got to be looking at this and saying to yourself, okay, how does it all fit in? Because if the dollar is going to rally much stronger at some point, you might find that the internet multinationals start to weaken. So I'm going to be watching that really closely. More importantly, let me just go back to this. So now what you've got is this floating letter from the trough in the S&P cash at 1646.47, 5 days ago. Yep, 5 days ago. And now you've got a leg A that went up to 1711.03. Now, I like to call this the gray A. All I'm doing is it's descriptive. It isn't a negative. It isn't a positive. It is just merely what it is. It's an explanation. An explanation of the waveform in its current position underneath the previous high, major high at peak C slash G. Remember the SPY made a D. The S&P futures made a D. And now what we're looking at, that 1729.86, because this pullback that we saw into last Wednesday didn't go underneath the 1627.47 low of the 24th, was that? The 28th. A pattern here says at a rally at this particular point, if it goes to a new recovery high, would be called D. Because it can't be, there's no letter after G, so it would be called D. In the E-minis, I'd have no choice but to say, I'm carrying it through, and that'll be an E. And that's if this one goes all the way up without making a peak today, in the next day or two. So I just wanted to explain that. And there's nothing one can do. You have to wait for it to unfold. And to trade it right now means that if you haven't picked the within the bottom area, it's kind of difficult because at any point, you can get a failure. That's why I call it gray A, because it's underneath the major high. Once it breaks the other high, the left side high, you've got something else in place. So I'll try to go through that over the next week or so. It's one of the more, let's put it this way. In its simplicity, going A, B, C, D, it's a fantastic concept. When you get a variation, it means you have to understand the core analysis before you can really feel comfortable with the, and that's what I love to teach, is how do you trade that? Well, there are ways of doing it. We've just done it with two particular stocks that seem to be doing very well under these conditions. I don't know if they'll stay that way because this is going to be a very volatile day. But you got to trade what you see, and that's the best way to do it. So, okay. Now, I had a question about gold, an email about the GLD. Let's look at the GLD. The GLD has slipped off my area. The GLD has made a trough C, a G slash C, but this is very important to me. I love to use inverse ETFs whenever I can. For instance, if I go here, let me just go right here for a moment just to explain what I'm looking at. You see that? That looks like a mirror image. But look, this is the diamonds. This is the... Why is it only a 28? What did I just do? Oh, the dog, of course. This is the dog, the D-O-G, and it's gone peak A. I wonder if I can get this into quickly, get it into... I love the way this works. Look, on the way up... Now, I love to talk about, are you personally... Now, this is not for general consumption. I'm saying, are you personally one of those people... I know that there have been people here in the den, beyond Tiger, and I've subscribers as well, that are just fabulous at identifying shorts. That's their thing. I don't know what it is. They don't really know what it is. They just have a really, really good feeling for going short. And I say, use that to your best advantage. Now, what do I mean by that? I mean that if you have an inverted ETF, in this case, the 100% long, you buy the long, ProShares Trust Short Dow 30. It means they've made this particular composite as a short position. So in your IRA or whatever it is, if you don't like to short, you can just buy this and go long, knowing that you're really playing it on the short side. That's the DOG, trading at 28.56, up 0.06. Now, trading down 0.25, so that's up 0.21%. Trading down 16% is the DIA. And the DIA says, I've gone from in the 100, in the daily, what was this? Oh, this is the one that had the confusing thing. It went from G. I've done something a little different. You on the downside went to a trough C. On the upside, I've gone to a G. I believe that's the same as the Dow. And now on the way down, I've come to trough A, trough B. This is the Dow diamonds, trades 100% long the diamonds, B, C, D. And that corresponds exactly with what you're looking at, where you go trough D goes with peak D. And this is going to possibly be peak A if there's no new high in the diamonds today. And it'll be a trough A on the downside if there's no new low bar in the DOG. Now, I would just want to point this out. It's just an educational thing. There are times where I find I'm trading way better on the downside than the upside. Why? Because there are just a couple of little questions. And let me put it this way. I'm looking and working my way through stocks that are short or ETFs that would be short with greater clarity than I am in the other way, or it's the other way around. And as I say, there are some people that very quickly, very easily are able to short and do it very successfully, and other people, they don't like shorting, they just like to go long. In that particular instance, I love to treat the concept of the inverted ETF as a benchmark. So I wanted to bring that up. I just wanted to show that example, and we'll go right back to our story. We're looking at the GLD. I'm going to introduce the DZZ, and I'll show you what I'm looking at. I'll be right back. Basil Chapman, Tiger Conditions Hour, 877-927-6648.
You take a hands-on approach to managing your investments, and whether you're bullish or bearish on U.S. Treasuries, the ETFs from Direction Shares are there to help you magnify your perspective. Bull ETFs for a rising market and bear ETFs for a falling market. Direction Shares gives you the tools for both sides of the trade. Discover how we can help at directionshares.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction Shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction Shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction Shares at 800-851-0511. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors, such as traders and active investors employing dynamic strategies. Investors in the fund should understand the consequences of seeking daily investment results, understand the risk of shorting, and intend to actively monitor and manage their investments. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
With the launch of Tiger TV, TFNN has brought our programming to the next level. With Tiger TV, you can gain access to each host's charts and computer screens as they host their daily stock program. Whether it's Tom O'Brien, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, David White, Larry Pesavento, Andy Hecht, Victor Jones, or Daryl Martin, you can catch all of our technicians hosting their programs live and archived on Tiger TV for your viewing pleasure 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you haven't checked out Tiger TV, then visit TFNN.com and see what you're missing.
The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is the only software package available with a built-in Gartley and Butterfly pattern scanner that will scan thousands of stocks, ETFs, and indices each day to find these patterns and then make them available to you with just a single click of your mouse. Tom O'Brien and Dave White will be hosting a live event for all Art of Timing the Trade Chart subscribers on October 16th at 6:30 p.m. Eastern. And for a limited time, we're offering a promotion where new signups can gain access to this powerful charting software, as well as the live study session workshop coming up this Wednesday night for only $1. That's right, $1 for the whole month with the class included. Remember, this offer is only good till this coming Wednesday night when the workshop takes place live with Tom O'Brien and Dave White, so don't delay. For all the details, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
Who says you can't take it with you? TFNN says you can. With your mobile device and TFNN's live radio streams, TFNN has put it all in the palm of your hands. No special apps to download. No subscription fees for live radio or Tiger TV streams. We say you can.
Now let's go over to the dollar, because the dollar is going to be the generator. It is the generator of basically higher dollar, lower market. And what the dollar has done, and this whole uptrend, folks, has just gone sideways. The way it works, folks, is this.
We say you can. The Tiger Financial News Network. Smart investors and professional traders know you can. TFNN.com. Educating investors. Investors, Taz Market Research delivers to its subscribers expert commentary on the analysis of 15 different markets each day. Get this invaluable and timely information through the daily market research videos Taz Market Research produces each day before 9 a.m. The video analysis will include reports on currencies, interest rates, indices, metals, energies, grains, and more. You'll be able to gauge where high profitability setups are in each of the markets. Receive a free 2-week trial subscription to Taz Market Research videos on the front page of TFNN.com. Basil takes your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Hi, folks. Basil Chapman, Tiger Traditions Hour. And what we're looking at here is that the Dow is down 5, S&P is up 0.97. This is one of those sessions where you don't get too carried away either side. Just you got to wait for things to play out. You can see that any sign of no immediate conciliatory talk, and you've got a market that goes down 50, 60 points in the Dow, 6 points in the S&P, anything good, and you start bouncing right back. So far, there isn't real strength, but there's a fascinating strength in certain sectors. This is a rotational market. Don't be afraid. I mean, we are very fortunate. We've got a stock that's up, even more than I thought it was just a little while ago. Just today alone, it's up 5.33%, one that we just bought a couple of days ago. I have to say that I spent a lot of time trying to look at sectors that could be working here in this rotational market, because I don't know if I want to be in any of the indexes like the long Dow or the short Dow or the long S&P or the short S&P or the Qs or the QID in the NASDAQ. The whippiness is just not really worth it. If there wasn't this thing going on, you would be looking at a market that wants to move higher based on many other factors. Also the factor that The VIX is down in the 16s to the 15s. That to me is buying pressure. So this is going to be a very interesting couple of days. So let's put this together and say the DZZ, which is the DB, gold double short ETN. It's not an ETF or ETN. It's paper that they've got, not the stocks, because it basically trades, how can I put it? It trades the spot short, double short the spot price of gold. There, so if you're looking at it in the daily chart and the Chapman wave, this is the second buy mode, and it should go 1 penny above 704. It's at 698 right now to start leg D, and then it starts to bump into a lot of resistance, and that resistance starts off at 704 back on the 6th of August. And then there's a big move to the 722 area. So right in here, I would have to say, if I wanted to draw a left side, right side price time match, I would say that right in here, you've got the best chance. I usually prefer to take it to a particular candle, but I'll do this for now just to show. There we go, new parallel. That goes to today. All right, that's not good enough. I want to move it over to the most important candle that I was looking at there, and now we're going to go from this level. If you're looking at Tiger TV, you'll see me doing this work. There you go. And it says by the 21st of October. What's the date today? The 15th. So by early next week, that whole area going towards the gap down of 729 on the 10th of July, 729, to the high bar the following day at 712. So that whole area above 704 to 720, that area would be a target over the next few days. If, in fact, it pulls back, 677. Now let's put that together with the GLD, which trades at one-tenth the price of spot gold. Now, this is in a G/C on the downside. And that says, yeah, you should go to a G/C. You should go to a D if the GLD slips to 121.84, 1 penny below the low of 2 days ago. If that occurs, what happens is, what do you look for on the left side? Well, we've already broken the first support, so it's the candle. Let me get rid of this here. It's this candle right here that has a low of 122.73. Oops. Yeah, 122.73. We've already gone down to 121.85. So now you've got to look at the gap that hasn't been filled, and the high there is 120.59. So this whole area here is going to be very important for only one reason, and that reason is you want to see... I'm just trying to get that. I'm not going to be able to... You want to see exactly how... I'm missing it. Stop talking because I'm trying to do two things at once. You want to see exactly how that support level comes in. So the GLD, the MACD is still very negative. The stochastic is negative. No, the MACD is negative. The stochastic is still down in the 12% area, and that's pretty darn negative. But the MACD shows signs of a little bit of flattening out. So how the dollar, now I get to the dollar, how the dollar breaks into that ugly candle of the 18th of September with a high of 81.22, that's going to be key. I'll be right back. Dow's down 9. S&P's unchanged.
Andy Hecht, the host of the Commodities Hour, recently launched his newsletter service, the Technomental Commodity Report, and only 6 weeks in, Andy has already recorded a triple-digit winner. Andy advised his subscribers to purchase a long-term call option at 46 cents on July 11th, and then sent out a special update Friday, August 16th, advising his subscribers to close that position at $1.40. That's a 204% profit in just 5 weeks. The Technomental Commodity Report by Andy Hecht is released each Thursday morning, and right now you can get a month-long free trial to this subscription while locking in the low introductory rate of only $39 a month. Andy Hecht has been a commodities trader for over three decades. Let his experience work for you. Sign up for your month-long free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report today at TFNN.com.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a two-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your two-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Daryl Martin coined the phrase diagnostic trading, and we're happy to announce that his diagnostic box spread analyzer has finally been released. The diagnostic box spread analyzer helps you easily identify the best box spreads on Nadex in seconds, plus you receive access to the diagnostic deviation levels, as well as step-by-step training videos teaching you how to trade Nadex spreads so you can quickly master the mechanics of this simple yet powerful trading instrument. By pulling live data from the Nadex exchange, the Diagnostic Box Spread Analyzer does all the math for you, calculating risk, reward potential, distance to break even for both outright spreads and spreads used to hedge the underlying market. Visit the front page of TFNN.com today to get your two-week free trial to Daryl Martin's Diagnostic Box Spread Analyzer and gain access to the valuable information it can provide when trading the Nadex box spreads.
This segment is brought to you by Harmony Gold. For more information, just click the Harmony Gold banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. We're back. Now, let's continue looking at the dollar, DXY. The dollar index is a legacy. It got a nice surge, but actually, it's the candle of September the 19th. What did I say? 18th. With a high of 81.22 and a low of 80.06. That ugly candle, you want to clear it. You want to go above there. You want to be going towards the 81.50, 200 period exponential moving average. And you want the stochastic not to be at 73% in leg C. You really would prefer, I would prefer to see it in the 80% area. So far, everything's working okay. But the weekly chart says, wow, there's a lot of work to be done in the dollar. That's number one. Number two is... When I'm looking at the daily, sorry, the 120-minute chart, I did get a nice signal this morning, yesterday, that there'd be a sharp move up. I didn't expect to be quite as sharp, but once it took out the high of 80.60, made it 115 in the afternoon on the 10th of October, and once they took it out today, it says, I have to really call that B. I could call it G, but really, 91% of the stochastic, MACD's good. This is good action. And it says it's a good chance that if the dollar in the next couple of hours takes over tomorrow, takes an 80 point, or this evening takes an 80.70. That's the leg C up, and now you've got the sense that this moving average, which I can never remember which one this is. I think it's the 32. Yep, it's the 32 period. I wonder how long I'm going to keep that on for. 32 period is just being hit today, and it's going to, that'd be very positive. Why? Because it immediately brings in the 50, and that 50 says 81 is the target, and that's great, because what's the high? 81.22 of the 18th. That would be your upside projection. Now, where would the support, where would it turn into another one of those usual dollar H patterns? If at any point in the next 3 days, it takes out 80, I'd say 80.13 was the low of the 14th, but I'm not going to do that. If it closes under 80, there's a real good chance it's going to make that pattern. But wait a minute. There's its mirror image, not quite a mirror image, but close. The euro. Well, the euro is now in leg C down after making a peak E in the Chapman wave at the top. And it projects down to a potential trend line support. And this trend line support coincides it doesn't coincide. It says that a break below 1.346, the low of the 25th of September, gets you into that beautiful candle of what? Of the 18th of September, the one that was the ugly candle. So this is going to be really important. Now let's make it simple. If you get into the midpoint of this candle, somewhere around 1.343, and the dollar's case DXY, I think it's getting close. If it gets into, it has to close, I shouldn't say gets into. If it closes above 80.77, and right now it's trading at 80.60 with a high today of 80.70, so not much further to go. That's going to be a very big positive on the one hand, and on the euro, it'll be a negative. So now let's go to a couple of other things that I want to look at. CPST mentioned in the Dan a moment ago, Cub mentioned it. That's a nice looking chart. It's trading at $1.26, but I don't advise anyone, if you're just kind of tuning in and just as your thing is not the stock market, you just happen to be listening out of curiosity, don't grab the stock. It does have pretty good volume, but it's at $1.26. It could move 1.26 down to 1.16 or 1.14 or 1.12, the support. You realize that would be 14. That would be a quick 12, 14% decline in your stock. No matter how low price, your capital will be down. So that's the way you got to think of it. But I am doing just a chart pattern that says that if Capstone Turbine, Capstone Turbine, CPST, trading at $1.26, up 2 cents, if it's able to close above 128, taking it out is good because it starts leg C, but if it closes above, then all of a sudden you've got a strong leg B in the weekly, and the week has just begun. It's only one and a quarter days so far, but it's a very strong weekly sign that the ugly candle of the week of the 9th of August, where it went from $1.46 to $1.10, that's 56 cents. That's a huge decline, 20-something percent. That's a big decline. So that's a very positive if it can do that and hold. Monthly chart is improving, but there's nothing much to say until the month is finished. And the other one that was mentioned in the den is was DSX. Terry says, nice butterfly. Well, DSX, look at this. DSX was Diana Shipping. In the monthly chart, it's gone to a peak C and pulled back quite sharply, but it's trading at 12.06, up 27 cents. This stock, once upon a time, made a peak D. I remember this well. Let me renotate this. Peak A, there we go. Oh, man, I don't want an error. What happened there? Right there. Now look at this. You've got an A, you've got a B, you got a C, and you got your D. In the monthly chart, even that works in peak Ds. And what does it do? It goes from 950 back in June of 2006 to 4516 in October 2007. When this thing moves, it's got a history of moving from way back. But now it doesn't move. It moves intraday and daily, but the monthly chart is just improving, let's just say. Now look at this. The weekly chart made a peak D with a C1, C2, but it's a high-level consolidation. That says that this could be D/B. If I was to see this thing trade at 12.06 right now, but 12.47 or higher, I'd say, there's a great chance that this is going to go to a leg C and then a D in the monthly and recycle higher. A failure below 11, it's 12.06, 11.30, somewhere around 11.30, 11.20, says watch out, 10.85 is the 200 period exponential moving average support. On a daily basis, very nice action. Not great in the MACD yet. It's at 12.06. It's made a low of $11.16 on the 9th of October. So this is just leg B. It needs to really climb, not just above 12.42, the high of the 7th of October, but above 12.50. If it gets above 12.50, all of a sudden you're getting to see a pattern I really like, even though it's a jagged one, but it's a pattern that says, I am making a cup formation. And that's what you really want to see. So to make it real simple, there's your trend line that you got to watch out for. The first break has to be above 12.20. Next one is 12.42. And then once it goes above 12.50, that's not open territory, but it says, great, now the technicals can start to strengthen. And the MACD in the weekly chart, the fast moving average, can start to deflect up, make an M pattern. So now let's do something else. I want to look at, I wrote it down here. Yeah, Johnson & Johnson. Out of the blue, you're getting these stocks that were fantastic winners, and then big consolidation for many weeks. In fact, since July, when Johnson & Johnson made its 94.42 peak E high, and the 2nd of August, it's pulled back all the way to last week's low of 85.50. That's 9 points. That's a 10% correction. The reason why I talk about the gray letters is, look, inside that, until it breaks above the old high where I can start to have a double notation, I call this a gray A. And I have no choice yet. I don't have a sign in the weekly that says this is going to go all the way to the top. In fact, the monthly says nice action so far. Weekly says good improvement. It's the daily. Now, what do you call the daily? Now, this is going to be a really interesting one. Why? Because the last major low was at 85.85. I've seen so many stocks do these doubles. 85.85, there was one this morning, 23.23, another one, 32.32 yesterday. Anyway, that's got nothing to do with that. That's just coincidence. Now, let's look at this. You've gone to 85.50, a lower low, and a higher high. So you say to yourself, wait, this has to be brand new peak A, leg A, because it started off from a lower level. No, you've got to look at it in the context of the longer term. In the longer term, the two-bar reversal at 94.42, back on the, I think it was 94.42, back on the 31st of July, the little high-level consolidation that then failed, that's the level. So this is all retracement stuff. So yeah, it's great for intra-week and maybe intraday trading, but until you really got leg A, peak A. Leg B, higher high, about 92, pull back. Leg C, I can't do anything with it other than to say it's a counter-trend rally. Great rally from 85.50 to today's high of 91.46 earnings came out, and now it's fading with those earnings. So I'm looking at this and I'm saying, okay, you got Procter & Gamble, same sort of thing, great move up, and then it stalls. What is this? This is a brand new buy signal? Well, you've got to treat it so far as if it is some kind of a buy signal because it's had a very nice move up. But at the same time, you can't treat it as if it's a buy signal to a buy mode yet because it hasn't got the stochastic's not at 80%. MACD is expanding, but it's not above the 0% line. A lot of things going on. But it's the monthly charts of these defensive type stocks that has me intrigued. Peak F and Procter & Gamble. What did I say it was in J&J? I think peak E. Yeah, peak E. Look at Clorox. What's with these stocks? Clorox makes a peak D, goes to 62.70 CL as a symbol, pulls back, holds the 9-period moving average, and keeps climbing. This is a nice, now, this is a nice-looking chart. This is A to B to C. Oh, man, I had these done. I don't know what's going on in this. I don't want to waste time on this. Let's call this A, B, C, D, pulls back, A, B, C, still gray until it takes out the old high, but it could even get to a D. Why? Because it's got this rectangle formation. A rectangle formation, if you can identify it, says, within the context of the rectangle, certainly within the context of a shorter time frame, that would be in this case the 120, but this is a week, the daily, you can get a peak A to B to C, what I call it, inside buy signal to buy mode, that takes you toward, exactly to, or just above the previous major high, in this case 62.70. So there's still about another point or so to go, and then we get the real test for Clorox. But I'm saying to myself, wait a minute, you've got all these major players, you've got Amazon, you've got Google, you've got this, and then you got a Colgate-Palmolive or Clorox. Oh, this is Colgate-Palmolive, not Clorox. Colgate-Palmolive acting so well. These are the consumer goods that people don't give up very quickly, you see. So that's my interpretation. That's the reason why they're going to hold up longer than many. Look at the RTH. The RTH is the Market Vectors Retail ETF. It's made a peak G/C in the weekly. It's made a G/C in the monthly. But it had a longer and deeper pullback than many of the other sectors, and it's trying to go back towards the old high. If it goes towards the old high and goes above 56.68, that'll confirm a leg D in the weekly, and if it's this much, it extends the monthly chart. And this to me says, recession? What recession? Not if you're getting your consumer area still acting pretty strongly. So I'm watching this real closely because I suspect this is going to be the clue that when the RTH, and it will, eventually takes out the 54 support area, it's at 55.29. It doesn't sound like much, but in this particular thing, the prices can trade heavily within a 1 and a 2 point range. If it eventually takes out that level, that low of 52.23 made in August of this year, the week of the 30th, that is going to be really important, because if that gets taken out, all of a sudden you're looking at the 9-period moving average for the very first time since it broke out. This is amazing. Since it broke out a year ago, October of 2011, the RTH has not closed once. It's only nicked it a couple of times, but never closed below the 9-period exponential moving average. That is amazing. So the Dow's down 48, S&P's down 362. I'm watching this really closely. I'll explain something, and we're probably going to go to a break in a minute. My opening call, that's my daily newsletter, very comprehensive newsletter, gives everything from the wave count in the Dow every single day, the diamonds, the 120-minute chart. Holman made a peak, D in the diamonds at 152.88. I showed exactly what we're looking at here. The five quintiles that I look at, that's the 120-minute Dow, the 120-minute VIX, the Richard Arms short-term trading index, and the daily daily Dow and S&P index. And I write up a big report about each one of these things, as well as the E-minis. But most importantly, what I'm looking at here is that in my opening call, I made it a determination. I took a long time to think about it, and I said, at this particular point, I want to look at the stocks that I think can act very well. I don't know if they're going to, but my analysis says that they should. And because of it, I want to stay within one of our long positions, which is up just a huge percentage. I want to stay in that category because it's different to the marketplace. And I want to stay with these new, I want to try to get in, and we did, get into these new sectors that I think are acting very well. And I think that's very important. I'll talk about, and then on the short side, we do have shorts. I'll be right back.
Are you ready to ride the next bull market wave? Catch the Chapman Wave. Using the Chapman Wave methodology, Basil's very comprehensive daily newsletter, The Opening Call, gives the short, intermediate, long-term analysis for the key indexes. In his Trader's Corner, he gives a brief market summary and expectation for the day with possible trades, both long and short, which are reviewed daily.
A position subscriber sold recently for a 42% on parts plus a 64% on rest at Hertz Global as a core position for 6 months before exiting the position. A current position entered as a turnaround company with good technicals based on Basil's waveform is trading up to 170% of its entry point as a portion sold earlier for a 21% gain. Subscribers to the opening call can see the Chapman Wave techniques demonstrated and explained daily to educate investors. To get your 2-week free trial to the opening call, just visit the front page of TFNN.com. Also, don't miss Basil's program, The Tiger Technician's Hour, Monday through Friday at 11 a.m. Eastern on TFNN.
TFNN has just announced a special sale for 2 weeks only for the Gold Report to celebrate the 600th weekly issue of Tom O'Brien's Gold Report being published on October 22nd. TFNN is having a special one-time sale. From now until October 22nd only, you can receive 60 weeks of the Gold Report. That's 14 months for only $600. We're offering Tom O'Brien's dynamic weekly newsletter at only $10 a week, which is almost half off the regular monthly price. The Gold Report is published every Tuesday and provides subscribers with Tom O'Brien's expert commentary on the industry, as well as detailed information on a variety of mining equities. Take advantage of this one-time special offer and pay only $600 for 60 weeks of the Gold Report. This offer is valid for current or new subscribers. Everyone is welcome to take part in this special promotion as we celebrate the 600th weekly issue of the Gold Report. All the details are on the front page of TFNN.com.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
What's the one thing that pulls people back from the breakthrough that they're moving towards? What's the only thing that really stops people from taking action? You and I both know the answer, and sure, we can come up with the reasons why we're not where we want to be, but the only reason that we don't do more with our life is fear. Or if you're an overachiever, call it stress. Simply put, there's something that happened to us in our past that's holding us back from the life we deserve, yet you and I are okay, we're here. So why should we let our past control our future? Exactly. We shouldn't. Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes with TFNN.com, and when it comes to your trading and investing, I can help you overcome your fear of loss. Together, we'll turn weakness into strength with a system I've developed called Mastering Probability. I'll teach you how to make your money work harder for you than you do for it. I'll teach you the tools that provide financial freedom. Go to the homepage of TFNN.com, click on my name, Steve Rhodes, and begin your journey of mastering probability risk-free. It's time to become a pioneer of your future versus a prisoner of your past.
This segment is brought to you by BackTech Environmental. For more information, just click the BackTech banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
I'm Basil Chapman, Tiger Technician. Same thing with the QQQ Trust Series. At $79.98, it's at all-time high. It's recovery highs, 11-year all-time highs. And it's making this wedge formation. It's getting somewhat overbought. But the weekly chart is still 94% in the stochastic. MACD is very strong. Same thing in the monthly chart. And the 120-minute chart, if I use a phantom peak, yeah, we could call this peak D or leg D up right now. But to be safe, it's just I call it C just because at this point I have no need to have a phantom peak, even though they were parallel highs. But it's the daily. It's this old F, which is, if it starts to pull back from here, yeah, that's very negative because it's got the outstanding Chapman Wave Roman candle still hanging out there. Or is it going to be a leg, a peak A, and then a leg B with a peak B? If it continues, we don't know at this particular point. The technicals of the daily are good. The price is even better, but the technicals are just good, not great. And it's the month, the weekly and the monthly that are holding it up. And if you look at Apple, Apple is looking good. Apple's holding very well. Leg C broken out above the declining wedge formation, the one that I call the falling X. And look, it breaks out. It says the next level of resistance is going to be that former peak C minus, which is at 507.92. It's at 500.06. Where does Apple fail? Stochastic's at 82%. MACD is good, not great, but good. It fails if it closes under 492 to 490. That supports the 9-period exponential moving average support. But the weekly also is saying, hey, I'm holding very well. I'm looking like I want to get back in this rectangle formation over a period of time to the 513 area. I fail if I break under, as I say, that certainly that 492, 490 area will be key, because then 482 is the 9-period moving area. So far, Apple's acting very well. I think it's stock selection here. It's imperative. Don't worry. For instance, I have been wanting to get back into the home builders. I've just been very afraid. Look, if one of my favorites, Toll, look at that, H formation, what's the Lennar, I always think of Len down in Cape Coral, our fantastic tiger who's done unbelievable, he's a magnet when it comes to real estate, buying these properties, hundreds of them. You've got Lennar, it's down at $1.06, look at KBH. So I'm a little cautious here, very selectively long, and selectively short. I will only know later on, tomorrow or the next day, if my short's going to work out. Maybe in the next hour there's a news thing and market pops. But if you're looking at this, selectivity, I'm going to emphasize it again. It isn't the TLT. It's the volatility index. I've said this for 3 years now. Watch that volatility index. If the VIX climbs above yesterday's high of 17.74, it's a 16.51. This market is going to take a breather. If, in fact, it holds either here or it slips under, it's at 16.51, slips under 16, especially if it takes out the low of 15.46 of 3 days ago, this market is going to climb and climb very strongly. It's really news-based. If it wasn't news-based, we would probably get a couple of further days of moving up very nicely. But at this particular point, we are vulnerable to both sides of the coin, and that's why I want to be on both sides of the coin. So coming up next, we've got the options hour, the fabulous show. And if you're thinking about options, what you do in this particular environment, call North Van Hooser. He's the host of the options hour, Think or Swim, coming up. Then you've got Daryl Martin, then you've got Dave White, you've got Andy Heck Tuesday, and then Tom O'Brien, 4 o'clock to 6. Don't forget to go to Front Page. Check out Tom's amazing gold report and the amazing 600 edition offer that's going on right now. This is the time to do it. Perfect time to do it. Basil Chapman, check out my opening call, Front Page of TFNN. And I'll be back. I'll be back with Tom later on today, I believe. Thanks for being here.
Patterns, profits, and peace of mind.
Are you looking for a precision edge in the market? Something that can stack the odds in your favor? Then look into Larry Pesavento's trading newsletter.
Patterns, profits, and peace of mind.
In each weekly issue, Larry explains what's going to happen in the markets based on the pattern he sees developing and gives you actionable trade ideas based on those patterns. Plus, you'll get his detailed analysis on a variety of markets and sectors, including stocks, treasury bonds, the gold market, oil, the dollar, the Forex market, and more. You'll get access to all the patterns Larry is seeing in the markets, plus the astroharmonics and powerful Bradley stock market model that Larry utilizes for less than $5 a day. An extremely potent combination that will give you the edge you've been looking for. Try Patterns, Profits, and Peace of Mind absolutely free for 2 full weeks. That's an $85 value. Yours free when you register right now.
Get Larry's Patterns, Profits, and Peace of Mind.
And get the edge you've been looking for.